الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. My brothers and sisters, we have just begun a new year and 1 month has quickly gone by. But in this short space of time, we can already get an idea, and Allah knows best what will happen in the rest of the year, what is going to occur in the coming 11 months. My brothers and sisters, we have been reminded on a daily basis about the political unrest in this country and a possible world war that is about to take place. We have a forecast that our economy in the future, in this coming year, is going to be bleak, which means that there will be a rise in inflation, which could probably mean that things are going to become more expensive. Every day we are reminded about racism in society. Even the royal family is not safe from. Crime is going up and society is becoming increasingly perverted. And later this year, they will even make it mandatory in our schools to teach our children about zina and to teach them about zina-based relationships. That's the world we have created for ourselves to live in. But the dunya itself, the earth itself has issues. The world's temperature is rising. We have had mudslides in Brazil. We have had a terrible earthquake in Turkey. May Allah make it easy for them and have mercy on their deceased. A deadly disease is coming from China and is spreading around the globe, which could mean in the following year and the coming year, we will see more bushfires. We will see more natural disasters and more diseases that will afflict mankind. And our Imam spoke the truth. As-Sadiq al-Masduq, al-Amin, liman fi as-samaa, spoke the truth, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, La ya'ti amun. There is no year that comes. There is no year that begins. Illa alladhi ba'dahu sharrun min. Hatta talqaw rabbakum. Except that the following year, the new year that you begin, will be much worse than the year that you've already left. And this will continue to be the state of mankind until the hour is established with Allah. My brothers and sisters, for the Muslim, he is not scared of fitna. He doesn't fear fitna. Yes, the Muslim seeks refuge from falling into fitna, because falling into fitna is a test. And a Muslim doesn't want to go through difficulties. That's not what our religion teaches us. But it also teaches us that we do not need to fear fitna. Because when a Muslim is tested, it is a chance for him to get closer to Allah. When a Muslim is tested, it is a chance for him to improve and have his status elevated with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When a Muslim is tested, it is a chance that his sins will be expiated, and all of this is bound to happen to every single one of us. أَحَسِبُ النَّاسِ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا. Do you think that you'll be left alone by saying, we believe, and Allah is going to leave it at that? وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. And you will not be tested. But for the Muslim, my brothers and sisters, for the Muslim, if there is a fitna that occurs, he has a perfect Lord who has given him a perfect religion. And if there are difficulties that he faces, or difficulties that he is going to face, this religion tells us that you need to prepare. The famous companion, An-Nu'man ibn Bashir, radiallahu anhu, he said, Al-halaka kullu al-halaka. Loss and all forms of loss is found. أَيُؤْمَلْ بِالسَّيِّئَاتِ فِي أَزْمَانُ الْإِبْتِلَاءِ. When a person continues to do bad deeds, when a person continues to corrupt himself, when a person continues to be negligent and he doesn't want to learn, when clearly he can see that the world around him is going down the wrong direction, Nu'man radiallahu anhu said, this is loss and all forms of loss. But greater than that, my brothers and sisters, we have the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who taught us and told us how to prepare. He said, لَيْسَ آمٌ إِلَّا الَّذِي بَعْدَهُ شَرٌ مِّنْ لَا أَقُولْ آم أَمْتَرْ مِنْ آم. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, every year is going to get worse. And I don't mean that he's talking about the seasons. I don't mean that one year is going to have more rain than another year. وَلَا أَمِيرٌ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَمِيرٌ. And I'm not saying that one government is going to be better than another government. I'm not going to say that you had rulers in the past and your rulers are going to get worse. Rather, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, each generation will get worse, but how? لَكِنْ ذَهَابْ أُلَمَائِكُمْ وَخِيَارَكُمْ. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, each year is going to get worse when your ulama leave you, when the people of knowledge leave you, when the righteous from amongst you have left their homes. When, my brothers and sisters, when we are in that state, our Islam will become weak. The Prophet ﷺ then said, a consequence, what will happen of good deeds and people with good deeds leaving you. ثُمَّ يَحْدُثُ أَقْوَامٌ يَقِيسُونَ الْأُمُورِ بِأَرَائِهِمْ. Then people will start talking about the affairs, all affairs, without any religious basis. People will start having opinions without realizing that they need to base those opinions on what Allah says and what His Messenger says, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And as a result, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and as a consequence, he said, فَيُهْدَمُ الْإِسْلَامُ وَيُثْرَمُ. Islam will then be destroyed, and it will be dismantled completely. Then Islam will be destroyed, and it will be dismantled completely. My brothers and sisters, without preparing for what awaits us ahead, without working on ourselves, without working on our iman, without stopping the things which are making us weak in our iman, without proper knowledge, basing our thoughts on proper knowledge, without making decisions based upon guidance from Allah and the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with what he left us in his sunnah, he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, فَيُهْدَمُ الْإِسْلَامُ وَيُثْرَمُ. Islam is becoming corrupted, as we can see it in front of our own eyes, by our own very hands. My brothers and sisters, may Allah aid us from the greatest fitna which affects us all, whether you are interested in politics or not, are the decisions that people are making, the policy makers are making. And for most Muslims, we are worried about what is happening in this country, and we are worried about what is happening in our own countries, and we are worried about what is happening in the Middle East and the peace there. That's true. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Al-fitna akbaru min al-qatl. Fitna and corruption and discord and confusion is worse than spreading killing. But let's remember, my brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam lived in Jahiliyyah. He lived in a social setting where the worst of all major sins were taking place. This means that his sunnah, this means his guidance as living as a minority, where the majority are not doing the right thing, is still relevant today, and possibly we can probably even say is most relevant than it has ever been after the Meccan period. So what did he do, sallallahu alayhi wasallam? What did he tell us about? How did he react when wars broke out between tribes in Jahiliyyah? When the relationship of the situation in Jahiliyyah was very bad politically, what did he tell us? He said, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, distance yourself, isolate yourself, and seclude yourself. He himself, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, used to go out to Hira, and he didn't want to witness the falsehood that was going on in Quraysh. He didn't speak about issues which had no benefit. And this is the advice that he gave throughout Islam. Hudhayfa ibn Yaman radiyallahu anhu said, كان الناس يسألون رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن الخير. The people always used to come to the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and they used to ask about the good things, about the good times, about the good rewards. وَكُنْتُ أَسْأَلُهُ عَنِ الشَّرِّ. But me, myself, Hudhayfa is speaking, radiyallahu anhu, I used to ask the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam about the bad things that this ummah is going to see ahead. Why? مَخَافَةَ أَنْ يُدْرِكَنِي. Because I feared that I would fall into it. Hudhayfa ibn Yaman radiyallahu anhu is teaching us a very important lesson. That the way that you can prepare yourself for fitna ahead is to educate yourself. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam gave him prophetic advice. تَلْزَمُ جَمَاءَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَإِمَامَهُمْ. Stick to the main body of the Muslims. Stick to the main body of the Muslims and their imam and their scholars. Stick to what is sound and stick to upright knowledge that is coming your way. But Hudhayfa then asked, radiallahu anhu, and this is from his hikmah and his wisdom and his intelligence, because if there's going to be a fitna, then unity is not going to be found. Scholars are not going to be easily found. So he said, what if I don't find this? What if I don't find an imam that can guide me? What if I don't find a group of Muslims around me which are upright? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, فَاعْتَزِلْ تِلْكَ الْفِرَقْ كُلَّهَا. Stay away from all of those groups. Stay away from all of the politics. Stay away from all of the discord. وَلَوْ أَنَّ تَعَدَّ بِأَسْلِ الشَّجَرَةِ. Even if you have to bite to the root of the tree to gain your sustenance, the only water that you can find is in the root of the tree, and that is the only way that you can stay alive, then do it. Hatta yudrikakul maut wa anta ala dhalik. Stay like that. Be a stranger. Stay away from discord, even if you die in that manner. This is politics, my brothers and sisters, but what about the economy? May Ar-Razzaq enrich us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam left us guidance for this also. And it's important for us to know that our money, my brothers and sisters, our money is connected to our iman. This is because Islam is a lifestyle, and that a person leads this lifestyle to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if he makes the wrong choices with his money, that will affect his iman. And if he makes the wrong choices with his iman, that will affect his money. And if there are individuals like that in society who are becoming weak in their iman, and they are becoming weak financially in their dealings with other people, it won't be long until the whole economy is affected. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam teaching us a concept, he said, that only a Muslim can really understand. He said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, al-bay'an bil-khiyar ma lam yatafarraqa. Both the buyer and the seller, both the employer and the employee, must discuss their terms before they agree. فَإِنْ صَدَقَا وَبَيَّنَا. If they are truthful and they have been clear in what they want from each other, بُورِكَ لَهُمَا فِي بَيْئِهِمَا. Both parties, if they are truthful and they do what they said that they were going to do, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, they will then be blessed in their money. وَإِنْ كَذَبَا وَخَتَمَا. But if they lie, or if one of the parties lie, or if one of the party cheats the other party, or if a worker doesn't do his work properly when he was supposed to do his work while he is at work, or if an employer cuts corners, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, muhika barakatu bayihima, all blessings and all goodness will be removed from their money. Allahu Akbar, my brothers and sisters. This hadith is telling us, yes, a Muslim wants to be good with Allah, and Allah will bless you in that. But this hadith is also telling us that the way you treat other people, the way that you deal with other people, also affects the blessings in your life. And for the Muslim, complete blessings is found when he knows who Allah is and how to obey him. But he also knows who has rights from the creation over him and how he can fulfill them. Also in the year ahead, my brothers and sisters, may Allah protect us, is SRE. Sexual and relationship education that is going to be made mandatory in primary and secondary education. And the way we tackle that is very complicated. But if we have to simplify the answer, then it's found in the statement of Sa'id ibn Mansur, one of the Salaf, rahimahullah. He said, "Allimu awladakum wa ahlikum al-khayr." The parent is the one who must teach himself and his family members of goodness. The parent, not the school. It is your responsibility to teach and educate your children, not the school. The school should be a supplement. The school should be something on the side. The primary learning that should be happening in his home, especially when it comes to his religion, should be done by the parents. So speak to one another with goodness, he said, rahimahullah. Learn what Islam says. And then he said, rahimahullah, wa addibuhum. Teach them manners. Teach them respect. Teach them respect for those people who we don't have the same opinion with. Teach them tolerance. Even if you disagree with their religion, even if you disagree with their sexuality, we can still live with them in society in a respectful manner. My brothers and sisters, we all need to start working and preparing right now for what is about to occur. And only Allah knows whether it's going to be good or whether it's going to be bad. But we need to start now before it's too late. And if you do, you have a promise from your Lord that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you. وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَمَعَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن والسنة أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم استغفر الله واتوب إليه الحمد لله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أما بعد my brothers and sisters what is not strange that society is going down a very bad path. This is not strange. It is not strange that people are going to get worse. What is strange is that people expect to be safe. People expect to be safe without doing anything about their iman. That is what is strange. My brothers and sisters, there is no way for us to be safe in a world when the world is full of uncertainty. Nobody knows the unseen, but we have a form of prevention. We have a way of blocking any kind of bad that comes towards you. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Izhad fi dunya yuhibbukullah." Make sacrifices in the dunya to benefit for your akhirah. Make sacrifices now and prepare for the akhirah. Live for the akhirah and realize that your land here is not permanent. Allah will love you. What this hadith is telling us, my brothers and sisters, is that your prevention is in sacrifice, and sacrifice is your prevention. My brothers and sisters, Islam, despite telling us that there is going to be fitna, it is still a religion which is very optimistic. It tells us to be realistic. It tells us to be cautious and look out for bad things that are happening around you. And this year could be a very turbulent year, to say the least. But Islam is very optimistic. Sheikh Abdul Aziz bin Baz, rahimahullah, said, "Laysa ma'na." In talking about the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he said that every year is going to be worse, laysa ma'na, this doesn't mean anna zaman da'iman yakun sharrun mimma qabla. This doesn't mean that every year that comes after a following year that precedes is going to be worse. What it means is that the world in general is going to get worse, he said, rahimahullah. The world is going to become a more and more horrible place for us to live in, and that's going to happen. But he said the meaning of the hadith, rahimahullah, is that it is possible that some people and some homes and some communities are not affected. It is possible that they are not affected, and in actual fact they can improve whilst the rest of the dunya is getting worse. Imagine this, my brothers and sisters, while the world is in turmoil, you and your family and your community could be safe and untouched from any fitna. But how? How if our places of worship are remaining empty? How, if our iman keeps sliding down and we are not doing anything about it? How are we going to improve and save ourselves from fitna if we can't attend the salah in the masjid and always opt to pray at home? How do we expect to get better when we don't want to attend lectures and the only knowledge we want to receive are short clips and short links that we have on our mobile phones? How, when we leave our children to raise themselves and we are not their best friends, we don't know what's happening in their lives? How, when we want our children to be safe, our families to be safe from the hellfire, but in the dunya, we have no time for them? How, when husbands want their wives to look and behave like angels, but they themselves are falling short? How, when our wives don't show respect to their husbands, but they want all of their rights and they want harmony? How are we going to improve and protect ourselves from fitna when society is losing iman, when society is losing Allah, when society is not worshipping Allah anymore? But Islam is telling us to improve in the opposite direction from what society is going in. Islam is telling us to have love and care for our Lord and our religion, for one another, and improve in our manners. My brothers and sisters, there's a lot of good in us and we need to preserve it. But at the same time, there's a lot of ignorance. And if we are awake, this will be a good year for us with the permission of our master. My brothers and sisters, Allah commands us to send peace and blessings upon our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah says, "Inna Allaha wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'alan nabi. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, sallu 'alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa zid wa barik 'ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa 'ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Oh Allah, help Islam and the Muslims. Oh Allah, help Islam and the Muslims. Oh Allah, give honor to Islam and the Muslims. Oh Allah, give us peace and comfort in our homes, in ourselves and in our communities, ya Rabbal Alameen. Oh Allah, rectify our wrongs. Oh Allah, forgive us for our mistakes and our sins and help us to get closer towards you, ya Rabbal Alameen. Oh Allah, help the Muslim Ummah wherever they are. Oh Allah, help the Uyghurs in China. Oh Allah, help the Rohingya in Burma. Oh Allah, help the people of Syria and Palestine and in Iraq and Yemen and any other place where there is difficulty, ya Rabbal Alameen. Oh Allah, guide us to the truth and keep us united on it and keep us firm until we meet you, ya Rabbal Alameen. Oh Allah, save us from fitna. Oh Allah, save our children from fitna. Oh Allah, save us from shirk and losing our iman. Oh Allah, make us firm upon iman, upon tawheed and all of the things that are beloved to you. Oh Allah, give us strength and give our community strength because some of us are weak. Oh Allah, give wealth to those who are poor. Oh Allah, give a cure to those who are sick. Oh Allah, have mercy on our deceased. And oh Allah, we ask you for your Jannah and we ask you to spare us from your fire. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wa salamun al-mursaleen. Wa akhiru da'wana. Anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.